good, you know, for a lot of reasons, to have another talented player out on the court, for depth purposes, you know, for like he got the toughness chain. He's the toughest guy on our team. I expect him to get it a few more times. And just having another active live body, you know, a guy that just knows how to play basketball out there is definitely refreshing for me.
What he said, it's, you know, it was a pretty sharp change in mentality going from, oh, I'm going to redshirt to, oh, I'm on the court now. How did you and the coaching staff work with him to get him to feel as comfortable as you could in such a short amount of time?
Yeah. So what we did from the start is we told him we were going to be really aggressive trying to get his waiver in. You know, that's what we did. And so we always told him to be ready. We prepared and practiced as if he were going to be eligible. And, you know, we were lucky enough to get his waiver. And now here we are.
Coach Tanner Barth here from WWAY. I hope you're doing well. Okay. You know, obviously you want to find a way to win a ball game no matter what. But, you know, your first win inside Trask Coliseum, obviously you would have liked to have fans. But kind of take us through what that was like for you and, you know, having the opportunity to finally get it done.
I've always dreamed of being in this moment, you know, being able to coach in this building as the head coach. And it's special to me. You know, fans or no fans, it's special to me. I think Trask is one of the, you know, venues that I think is a little undervalued, you know, nationally. I think it's one of the best in the country. And to be able to be the head coach here and get my first win tonight in Trask was special to me.
Now, Coach, you were here during some real rowdy atmospheres. How different is it coaching when you hear everything? Because I remember in the second half there was a timeout, and we could hear almost everything you were saying during that. It's just different.
I love it. I love it. It's like I'm in practice. If you know head coaches, I like practice way more than the games. And for us, for me, I know that, you know, sometimes in games when it's a big crowd and you're yelling at one of your players, sometimes they can act like they don't hear you. Well, I know you hear me now. So it's one of those situations where I love it. I love, you know, being able to coach my guys on both ends of the floor and knowing that they can hear me a little bit. Now, it is different. It is different. But when you're in game mode, I don't really think you pay much attention to it.
Coach, you know, John just mentioned, you know, we could hear everything. You guys up 38, and, you know, you were really passionate with your players. You know, what were you trying to urge to them in that moment, you know, to continue to play hard basketball?
Those games are hard. And, you know, I want to give a lot of credit to St. Andrews. They were out talented today. And but I want to give a lot of credit to them. But those games are hard. And I kept telling my guys to fight human nature. Human nature, when you're up big like that, is to relax and start doing things that you don't normally do, or, you know, let things happen that you don't normally let happen. So I was on them about that. I didn't like the fact, and I think I know what you're talking about. I didn't like the fact that they were shooting at the time 53% on us for the game and like 58 from in the half. I didn't like that. And so I was on them about getting stops, because that's the area that we have to improve in. And I'm never satisfied. Coaches are never satisfied. And I always think we can improve. So I was just on them about that.
What does a game like this do? Like you said, they were outmanned. But does this allow you to kind of work with some rotations? We saw Ian for the first time. You were able to get some guys some minutes. Is this going to be something that will help them down the road?
You know, I don't know. I think, you know, a lot of different – I was thinking through a lot of different things. You know, I wanted to give, you know, guys like Mike and Jamari, guys like that, I wanted to give them some rest, because we've had a long week and we got a tough stretch ahead of us as well. So I wanted to give some of those other guys a break, and I wanted to give guys like Ian and you know, guys like that, BT, guys like that, an opportunity to play and try to get more comfortable and see if they can help us, you know, when we get to a point, you know, this weekend or the week after. Like, I want to see if they can help us, because I want to start shortening my rotation down here in a few weeks. So I'm still trying to figure that out. So it was a lot of different things I was trying to think through.